Hello friends, welcome back to anujindal.in. So in today's video, I'm going to discuss with you that what is the job profile of a SEBI grade A officer. So this is one of the most searched queries by students, that what is the job profile. So let me tell you one thing in advance, that the job profile of a SEBI grade A officer is really very interesting. So let's start. So in this video, we will discuss what is the training period, what is the probation period, okay? Then what are the, next we will discuss what are the job responsibilities of a grade A officer. Then what are the different departments in SEBI in which you can be posted. Then the working hours, okay. Then what is the career path or what are the promotions available to a grade A officer. And finally, what are the leaves, okay. So let's begin. So first of all, as soon as you join the organization, first of all, you are given a 6-week in-house training at NISM. NISM is National Institute of Securities Market, okay. So this institute, it offers a lot of certification courses. You must have heard about those certification courses. So NISM offers a lot of certification courses also. So you are given a 6-week residential induction program, and in this 6-week program, you are made aware of the different departments of SEBI and about the working of SEBI, okay. And once you complete this induction program, then you are given a particular department, okay. And the probation period of a grade A officer is 2 years, okay. Only after you successfully complete 2 years, you are made permanent, okay. So 2 years is the probation period, and if your performance is satisfactory in those 2 years, then you are made a permanent employee of SEBI, okay. Now next is, what are the job responsibilities of a SEBI grade A officer? So as I told you, after your induction training, you will be posted to different departments or offices. Okay, so there are a lot of regional offices of SEBI also in different states. So you can get posting in headquarters, which is in Mumbai. So initially, candidates get posting in headquarters only, and after that, maybe after 5 years, they can get posting in their home state or in some other state, okay. So employees may be posted to different departments and offices and assigned work on areas ranging from policy formulation. So you can be given the work of policy formulation. You can be given the work of intermediary registration. So who are intermediaries? So in stock market or in capital market, the various intermediaries can be custodians, investment bankers, okay. Then there are other intermediaries, stock exchanges is also an intermediary, okay, stock brokers. So a lot of intermediaries are there. So their registration, their supervision, okay, inspection, okay, very, very important, inspection, supervision, investigation, adjudication, okay, and handling of investors' complaint. So these are some of the job roles which you can be offered after joining as a SEBI grade A officer, okay. So there are different departments in SEBI. I will discuss those departments. So you can be posted in any one of those departments, okay. Then this SEBI grade A job, it is a mix of field and desk job, okay. So it is a desk job also, and it is a field job also. So field job in the sense that you can be sent for inspections, okay. You can be sent for inspections of intermediaries, inspections of stock exchanges, okay. So these inspections, you can be sent either within the state, so it can be within the state also, or it can be outside the state also, okay. You can be sent for inspections either within the same state in which you are posted or outside the state, okay. Then work exposure is really, really good in SEBI. Okay, you get exposure as you get exposure in a corporate sector. The same exposure, almost similar exposure you get in SEBI. Okay, that is why there is a lot of demand of SEBI grade A officers in private sector also. And then finally, there is no hierarchy barrier. This is very, very important. In SEBI, you don't have a rigid hierarchical structure, or you don't have bureaucracy in SEBI. You can easily approach the top management or the directors. So there is no hierarchy barrier. Okay. Now let me discuss the important departments in SEBI in which you can be posted. Okay, so you know there are different streams for which you are recruited. So there is a general stream, okay, there is legal stream, there is IT stream, there is research stream, okay, then there is engineering stream, official language, okay. So these are the different streams in which you can apply in the examination, okay. So let me discuss the different departments. So first is the market intermediaries regulation and supervision department. So as the name suggests, this department is concerned with the registration of intermediaries, their regulation and their supervision, okay. So the in all these departments there are various divisions. So these departments are divided into various divisions. So ultimately you would be posted in a division of a particular department, okay. Then there is market regulation department, then investment management department, then IT department. So those candidates or those students who get selected in the IT stream, they will be posted in the IT department, okay. Then legal affairs department and inquiries and adjudication department. So legal affairs and adjudication department, so those candidates who apply in the legal stream, those candidates who apply in the legal stream, they will be posted in one of these two departments, legal affairs department or inquiries and adjudication department. So if I talk about legal affairs department, so legal affairs department is concerned with preparing the policy notes, giving opinions to other departments and filing of legal cases. So SEBI also files a lot of legal cases, right? And if I talk about inquiries and adjudication department, so this department is concerned with filing of show cause notices and attending the various proceedings in tribunals or courts, okay. Now next is general services department. So in this department there are two divisions, facility management division, although there are more divisions, but I will discuss these two divisions, facility division and official language division. So those who get selected in the engineering stream, they generally get posted in the facility management division, and those who apply in the official language stream, they get recruited in the official language division, okay. Then there is corporation finance department, then commodity derivatives market regulation department, then department economic and policy analysis, DEPA, okay. Then there is recovery and refund department, and then there are other departments also, okay. I have mentioned a few of them, but there are other departments also. And moreover, there is one very good thing about SEBI, that after every 5 years, your department is changed, okay. So you get to work in different departments in your career, which gives you a lot of, you can say, experience, and which gives you a lot of experience and exposure. And also there is no stagnancy, as you get to learn new things by being posted in different departments, okay. So there is no stagnancy. So in every 5 years your department is changed, and in every 1.5 years, in every 1.5 year your division is changed, okay. So this is really very good in work, this is really very good work culture of SEBI, okay. Now next is so I discussed the responsibilities and I discussed the departments. Now these are some of the general responsibilities, okay, like approval of stock exchanges bylaws, okay, amendment of bylaws of stock exchanges, so these are generally connected with your policy making, okay. Then inspection of accounts of stock exchanges and various players. So as a grade A officer, you will inspect the accounts of stock exchanges, you will be sent for inspections, and you also inspect the accounts of various intermediaries, okay, like stock brokers, okay, custodians, underwriters. Then identify and investigate any malpractices within the security market, very very important investigative function of grade A officer. Then you also take measures for increasing investors' knowledge on securities market. So investors' education is another very very important function or very very important role you have to play. Then suspension of security tradings of a stock exchange, then granting and withdrawing recognition of a stock exchange, and taking care of SEBI's legal concerns. So these are some of the responsibilities as a grade A officer. Now what are the working hours, okay. So in SEBI there is a 5-day week, that is Monday to Friday, okay, and the timings are 9:30 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. So 8 hours shift. there is a 8 hours shift. And there is also one good thing about SEBI that there is flexibility also in the working hours. So you can come early and leave early. This is also permitted. Okay. But apart from that, one thing I want to tell you is that SEBI is not like a general government office. It is more like a corporate office. So the work pressure, or you can say the tasks, are somewhat challenging. Okay. So you may have to work on weekends also sometimes if you are given an assignment. So sometimes you may have to work on weekends, or you may have to stay late in the office to complete the work. Okay. But I think that is not a cause of issue, because SEBI grade A officer being a very reputed and prestigious post, you are expected to give your extra, okay, and to give your best, okay. And apart from that, if I talk about opportunities, so there are also opportunities for foreign postings and deputations, okay. There are also opportunities for foreign postings and foreign deputations, okay, for one or 2 months, okay. But one thing you have to be very sure is that SEBI does not have any office outside India. So you will get posting in a foreign regulator. So foreign regulators, like regulator of some other country, they may hire you. Okay. You can be posted in the offices of foreign regulators. So these type of foreign postings are possible. So there is a lot of exposure available in SEBI. Okay. Then next is, what is the promotion or what is the career path as a grade A officer? So you are appointed as a grade A officer, which is equivalent to an assistant manager post. So you are get recruited as an assistant manager. After that, you become manager. Okay. So approximately it takes 3 to 5 years to get promoted to the post of manager. Then again, you will get promoted to assistant general manager. Again, it takes 3 to 5 years. So promotion takes approximately 3 to 5 years, depending upon your performance. Then after that, you become grade D officer, which is deputy manager. Then after that, grade E, which is general manager. And after that, grade F, which is chief general manager, CGM. And finally, you become executive director. And after executive director, you can become a whole time member or the chairman of SEBI. But post of whole time member and chairman, they are filled by Government of India on contractual basis. Okay. So the whole time members or chairmen, they are appointed by Government of India on contractual basis. And one very important thing is that grade A, B, C, grade A, B and C officers, they are given 2 BHK flats. Okay. Whereas grade D, E and F, after grade D, so grade D onwards, you are offered, grade D onwards, you are offered 3 BHK flat. Okay. And if I talk about promotion, so promotion is not time bound. Okay. So aisa nahi hai ki aapka 5 साल में प्रमोशन हो ही जाएगा या 3 साल में प्रमोशन हो जाएगा. प्रमोशन इज बेस्ड ऑन योर परफॉर्मेंस. ओके. परफॉर्मेंस ऑन द जॉब एंड इट ऑल्सो डिपेंड्स ऑन इंटरव्यू. सो प्रमोशन के लिए आपका इंटरव्यू भी होगा. तो आपकी परफॉर्मेंस और आपके इंटरव्यू के बेसिस पे ही आपका प्रमोशन होता है. और जनरली 3 to 5 years में आपका प्रमोशन हो जाता है. ओके. सो आई होप दिस इज वेरी वेरी क्लियर, द प्रमोशन पार्ट. एंड नेक्स्ट लास्टली आई वुड लाइक टू टॉक अबाउट द लीव्स. So what are the leaves being offered to a grade A officer? So as a grade A officer, you are given 12 casual leaves in a year. You get 30 ordinary leaves, 20 sick leaves, and these sick leaves are half pay. Okay. And you get 15 days paternity leave. Okay. So casual leave and ordinary leave, they are full pay. So your salary is not deducted. Okay. They are full pay leaves, but sick leaves, 26 leaves, they are half pay leaves. And paternity leaves, you get 15 days. So I hope guys you must have liked this video. मैंने इस वीडियो में आपको काफी डिटेल में समझा दिया है कि एज अ ग्रेड ऑफिसर आपको क्या क्या काम दिया जा सकता है. ओके. और आप कौन से डिपार्टमेंट में पोस्ट हो सकते हो और उन डिपार्टमेंट्स का क्या क्या काम होता है. उसके बाद हमने डिस्कस करा सेबी में वर्किंग आवर्स क्या है. देन वी डिस्कस्ड वॉट आर द वेरियस जॉब रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज. वी डिस्कस वॉट आर द वर्किंग आवर्स. वी डिस्कस्ड वॉट इज द job promotions, what are the various promotions which you can get. So in SEBI you can easily reach at the top of the ladder, because har 3 se 5 saal mein aapka promotion ho sakta hai. To aap kafi jaldi upar pahunch sakte hain, even aap executive director tak bhi pahunch sakte hain. So prospects are very, very high for a SEBI grade A officer. So friends, I will be coming up with more such videos in future. So stay connected with us. Prepare hard for your examination. If you have any query, you can ask in the comment section below. Have a nice day.